you doing? Welcome. Welcome back to the first show of the year 2017, the Nikki Clarke Show, here live at the Costco store in Scarborough. Yes, we're in Scarborough and we're at the biggest location here, Costco, and we're so excited to be part of this amazing production. I just want to wish everybody a blessed new year. This is going to be our year. 2017 is a year of abundance and it's a year of a prosperity for everybody. And what could be better than to celebrate it here at one of my favorite stores, Costco. So I'm here with an amazing entertainer. He is a producer and a singer. He's a reggae sensation. CASPER is going to be here. And also we have a financial expert, wealth management expertise, Sonia Dolar is here. So you don't want to go anywhere. We're here live at Costco in Scarborough, 1411 Warden Avenue, the Nikki Clarke Show. Be right back. Hey everybody, welcome back. Thank you. We are here at the Costco location, 1411 Warden Avenue in Scarborough, and I have a very special gentleman beside me. He is a producer and an amazing artist. He's got an album out and it's so hot. So please welcome reggae sensation CASPER to the
Hello,
show.
Hello everybody, how you doing?
Come on.
Everything Chris
on
yes,
Curry.
Yes.
Yeah, so thank you so much for being here, our very first time at Costco taping. What do you
nice.
Think?
I love it, love it, love it.
Yeah, nice yeah. vibes, nice yeah. vibes. Right here, we look across and we have the poultry and pork section.
And all the people.
The back. And all the people.
Shopping.
Hi, people.
Hello, hello.
Hey, hello, hello.
Hey.
They need coffee.
Yeah.
We perk here.
More smiles.
So, CASPER.
Yep.
How did you get that name?
Well, an American friend of mine, him and I sat down, he's a marketing dude, and he said, yo, you got vanilla ice, snow, M&M, why not CASPER? And I was like, and he's like, okay, CASPER it is. I said, what? And I said, okay, let's run with that. So I got CDs and my name on jackets, and it just took off from there. So he was right.
Okay.
He was right about that.
All right.
And then everybody in Jamaica calls me the Duppy Ghost.
So. The Duppy?
Yeah, the Duppy Ghost CASPER, so it's pretty crazy.
Okay, well, Jamaica, Duppy is patois for ghost, so, wow.
Well, CASPER the ghost, right?
Okay, and you're comfortable with that?
I'm cool. I'm a spiritual man, so I guess the ghost fits.
You know, you have an interesting background because you kind of got into reggae a little later on. How did that happen? You had a journey working with some Jamaicans and then something just fell into place. Talk about that.
Yeah, I come from a small town called Picton in the Jamaican Handfields. Come pick tomatoes and apples, and I had to learn the patois to communicate with them. And so what we did was I brought down a karaoke machine and we started doing some tapes.
So what kind of songs were you singing?
I was just chatting away, anything that would come off the lid, the top. And
what artists were you imitating?
I think Wayne Wonder was one of them. Bob Marley, some of those artists.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay.
So that was pretty tough.
And then
they were like, boom, you sound like one of us.
Yeah.
So I was like, cool, I've been practicing a long time.
Okay, so a star was born, and how long ago was that?
Oh God, we didn't want to talk that long. My God, I think I was 16.
Okay.
So we won't say my age.
We'll do the math right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, you guys do the math.
But it's been some time, honing the skill that you have. And then what happened? You started doing a little bit of performances, and then
I just grabbed the mic everywhere I could go, chat, do the reggae vibes, MC, and I don't know. Once I found the name CASPER from my American dude there, he's like, just took off. Put the jackets, everything went out there, karaoke bars, any show I could get on.
To get some exposure.
To get some exposure, and then boom, all of a sudden I got on this big show, and I'm here I'm opened up for Coco T, and it's like, boom.
Coco T, he's a legend.
Yeah, he's an icon, Jamaican artist. Yeah. He's big. And we did a combination together too, so pretty big. So I'm a person that I go for what I want, and Coco T is what I wanted. I got Freddie McGregor first.
Freddie McGregor, not too bad for a first-time duet.
Yeah, you know.
Okay, and then Coco T, and then who else? Did you work with Snow?
I haven't worked with Snow. I've met him many times.
What's he like?
I like him. He's inspired me to do what I do now. So he's a good guy. He's a good guy. And I always get compared to him. CTV.
I can see why.
CTV did a biography, a short biography on me, and they put in Snow as the
inspiration.
And I was like, cool. Okay. Everyone's like, you see the 6 o'clock news? I said, no. They compared you to Snow. I said, that's great. He's great. You sound great. Look at who he's worked with.
For sure.
Buju,
sure.
Terry Fowler, all of them.
Some of the greatest.
Nadine Sutherland.
So, awesome. So you've been to Jamaica regularly?
I've been to Jamaica probably counting a good 10 times.
You're going back this year?
Well, that's the goal.
Okay.
You know, but I've had some kids and stuff, so that's kind of been my inspiration.
Focus on the family.
Yeah, the family, personal.
Okay.
And, but that's my goal. I want to go back to Jamaica with my new single, We Are One.
So, and that's a hot track.
It's a hot track.
It really is.
Yeah, so awesome. It's doing well. It's in this magazine, front cover.
Let's take a look at that.
Lovers Magazine Worldwide.
And that's just one, the latest release that just came out.
2017, front cover. So check it out. Kelly Lee, respect.
Awesome.
So it's an independent magazine that helps out independent artists. So
you're not signed to a label, you're independent.
I have my own label, Unlimited Sounds Records.
Okay.
And that's done everything what needs to be done.
Okay.
I got about 24 albums worldwide.
24?
Working on, I guess when you do the math, it's probably 30, but who's counting?
Okay.
And I'm on the Nikki Clarke Show.
You sure are, and you've blown it up. And I just wanted to ask you, when it comes to being signed and unsigned, as an unsigned artist, what are the type of freedoms you have?
Well, I think the freedom is A, royalties, but B, you're creative in your own sense, like from music, lyrics, production. When you're signed to a major, they control all that stuff. So I've been lucky, so I've sent out a certain message, a certain production quality, but obviously I'm looking for a major deal too. So anyone out there, check it out, Casper, Twitter.
Awesome. Let me ask you something too, if you don't mind. Let's talk.
I don't know if I can do that. Let's talk.
You know, as an artist, sometimes you come across some challenges, right? And you know, you're in the genre of reggae music. So did you have any obstacles coming across, maybe because of, you know, your culture, your background, anything like that?
Yeah, tons of times. I've been thrown out of Jamaican clubs, stuff like that in the early
because
days
of
CASPER.
What you look like?
Because skin color, whatever, and they're like, you're not Jamaican. I go, nope, Canadian, but.
That's very close-minded, so they didn't even give you a chance. Yeah.
So, I don't know, like, challenges of being on front covers and stuff. Controversy of that being a white reggae artist, there's not, as you know, there's not very many here in Canada.
No, not at all.
Snow and myself.
That's the only one I can think of.
Whitey Don.
Whitey Don.
But other than that, and I think he's American, I'm pretty sure, but other than that, there's not too many of us.
Okay.
And he inspired me, Snow, so here I am.
So CASPER, you're going to just take it and run with it like Bolt.
Yes, take the world by storm.
Absolutely.
On the Nikki Clarke Show.
Okay, so can I ask you to do a little something
acapella?
For us? A cappella.
Well, I could do a little piece. Everybody's probably getting over a cold like I am, but. Ooh yeah, ooh yeah, ooh yeah, hey. I try to keep a smile upon my face, but every time I try, it slowly erase from my distress. But I know Jah keeps me blessed. You see, I never coulda lose the faith of the Father. Now rewind and come back with the next big tune, CASPER. When you wind it, girl, I love the way you come and move up them body. When you wind it, girl, I love the way you come and mash up the party. Let me tell ya, girl upon me left me send a girl upon me right. Hanging up on my yumba when I sleep to be the slider. Look on the dance floor, see the girl. Cha, Nikki Clarke, you the best.
Bruh, bruh, bruh.
Yeah.
Wow.
Well, not bad for a cold.
Not too bad for a cold.
Imagine if it wasn't there.
I'm telling you, wow.
Yeah.
You are so talented. Really, really.
Thank you.
Amazing, amazing. We got to get you all over. Casper,
well, that's the
Casper.
Goal.
Left,
take
right,
over
center.
The world, you know, like get
as
that
you should.
Next level. Level,
yeah.
You know, I've worked with the icons. I've even worked with Chip Fu, so big up Chip Fu. Marvin Prince. Don't know.
Okay.
Snow's producer that did the big tune Informer.
Mm-hmm.
So
Informer.
You know, see the man that snow me out there.
Aliki bom bom there. What
so.
Does that mean?
Yeah. What does
we'll
that
ask
mean?
Snow later.
Aliki bom bom there. I guess look up your bottom.
Oh yikes.
Something mm-hmm. like that.
It's not that kind of show.
No.
Yeah.
It's a godly spiritual show, Jack.
So you say you're a spiritual man. Have you
I
always
am.
Been?
Yeah, I've always been spiritual. I'm a type of person that I say hello to everyone, even if they don't say hello.
Okay, so you bring the light wherever you go.
Yeah, see, that's why I wear white. Bring the light. You
know? Absolutely. Well, it's been a pleasure having you on. And just tell us, how can we get a copy of this? And by the way, you have a treat for us, right? Everyone here in the audience, you're getting a copy of CASPER. So
see?
Hot.
Yes,
hot,
yes,
hot,
yes,
hot,
yes,
hot
yes,
up
yes.
the place.
Everyone.
Everyone, and you've got a magazine too. We've got some magazines.
Yeah, I got some reggae exclusive magazine. Big up Prince Everett, Donna Makita, everyone.
Awesome.
Big up my wife, my kids, love you.
What are their names?
Sabrina, Brianna, Nathaniel, love yous.
Awesome.
Yeah. So
you're a big daddy.
And, yeah, been a big daddy, so it's crazy. But you're great.
Thank you.
Spiritually, you're connected. You know, and your show's big and love it. I'm so glad to be here. It's
thank you.
First time we finally connect, you know.
I know. But I feel like I've known you for a long time.
Yeah.
Like a brother from another mother.
Exactly, a brother from another mother.
To God be the glory.
Yeah.
And tell us, how can people find you?
You can find me on at twitter.com, Casper110. That's O-N-E 10. Check it out. And this is on iTunes with many more of my albums, Casper. We Are One. So big it up every time, and also big up AVA Live Radio in Miami for putting me on the top 10 for We Are One.
Congratulations.
Yeah, so
that's huge.
Big up.
Did you hear that? Top
and,
10 in Miami. Make some noise.
And We Are One also award winning on the Academy Music Awards in California. I won top best reggae song in the US, so bless up.
So that's a lot of hard work, and I have to say that
it's the first single.
It's the first single
off the album.
Amazing.
It never happens that way.
Amazing. Well, so, because you're blessed and you're very talented and you're humble, and that's something I try to when I mentor artists to keep in mind. Like, you can be extremely talented, but your attitude is your latitude.
Exactly.
And you're very professional and you work hard, so you're just going to go straight to the top.
Don't burn your bridges. That's the biggest thing
I
can say to everybody, because those bridges, if they're burnt, you can't cross over them.
Yeah.
You'll be swimming and drowning.
Exactly. Yeah. So there's always an open door if you keep the door open.
Exactly.
Bless up, Casper.
Respect. One love to everyone
love
out
everyone.
There.
Thank
bless,
you.
Bless.
We'll be back. Show live at Costco in Scarborough, and sitting beside me is a good friend of mine. She's been on the show. This is our second time. Please welcome financial advisor Sonia Dollar to the show.
Hi, Nikki.
How are you doing?
Excellent. How are
awesome.
You?
I'm so so happy to be here and happy that you're here, and Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Thank you. Thank you. So what you been up to, Sonia, since we last had you on the show?
So it's been, I guess it's been about a year since we've seen each other on your show, but we've seen each other apart from that.
Absolutely.
And we met through Lena Gurgis.
Yes.
So been actually.
And she just had a baby.
And she had a baby.
So congratulations, so. Lena and Shadi.
And now there's a young stiletto in the making.
Yeah. So you've been busy in the community. I see your stuff on social media, and I know we've been trying to connect since that and get together, but you know, schedules don't always permit. So tell me what you've been doing.
So in the last few months, been very, very busy actually helping people with their financial planning independently, individuals and businesses, and been doing a lot of the entrepreneurship actually. So many different people have been kind of establishing themselves. Lucina, that's going to be a guest on your show in the near future. Also China Wine, which is another friend from Britain and Jamaica.
Awesome.
So we've been busy. She has actually got a shoe line just in the last week. Over the Christmas holidays, so that's been really, really super amazing. And so I'm helping her with that as well.
So you're managing her or helping her coordinate?
Well, I'm helping her coordinate all these different things and putting the contacts in place. And Chavez Shoes. So through, we, like Lena and a whole group of us know each other, and this is really the amazing thing about being an entrepreneur is to be able to help each other in, you know, in any way with contacts,
right?
Supplying information as well as networking with other businesses. And so each person has a specific purpose in their business, and it really comes to fruition. Like China, for example, she's been a singer. And the ability to kind of merge the artistic with the business, with the whole business sense comes into play. So also the Chavez Shoes has had a lot of success with Miss Universe pageants.
Really?
Absolutely. And I had the occasion to kind of get involved in that a couple of years ago. Mm-hmm. And they have specific different patents on things with shoes, so that you can actually have double functions, different size heels.
Oh, wow.
as well as inserts. So you get actually two shoes for two.
So you can adjust the heel.
You can adjust the heel on one, and you can also adjust the actual part of the color of the shoe.
Oh, that's
so
fantastic.
It's very, very amazing.
You know, because I go to functions and I start off low. Mm-hmm. And then as the evening progresses, they get a little higher. Mm-hmm. But I have to change shoes until I get to about the 3 to 6 inches that I need for that, you know, gala.
Yeah.
But in this way, you can adjust the size with the one shoe.
Absolutely.
That's fantastic.
It is really, really amazing. And they're putting it at a price point that it is affordable for many, many people. And so that's the whole beauty of the engineering and the efficiency. And this is all part and parcel of financial planning, is staying within budget, looking good, staying within budget, and being able to buy what you need and put away something for saving for the long term.
So how long have you been a financial advisor?
For the last 20 years.
20 years.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And what are three main things people need to know to manage their money well? As in, you're not born to know, so what are the three fundamental principles of... Mm-hmm. financial health?
Okay, so for financial health, it doesn't matter whether you're an individual, a family, or a business. You need to have a purpose. What is my purpose? What do I need to accomplish? What are the financial demands? So all of these, in order to create a financial plan and to look at your timelines, tax concerns, longevity. What is the purpose of the money? Before you can establish that, you can't really go, you cannot go any further. Also,
so you need a plan.
You absolutely cannot, you know, you cannot go with the plan.
Okay.
And if you don't have the expertise, you know, just find somebody that can help you with it. If there's things that you probably learned as a child, like home economics, that kind of thing, budgeting, but to really get the expertise. If you're a business, you need to get the expertise to be excellent in whatever you do in order to be successful.
And so they come and seek you for
that
kind
of advice.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And to be, to do, to really be successful, there has to be a presence of excellence, because you have to distinguish yourself from everybody else. And as well, to get to actually get you know, to find the product that you need, so that you don't have surprises. And as well, to kind of manage manage expectations, because without really understanding all the emotional issues, whether it's you know, issues with children, with spouses, with education, with learning disabilities, divorce, the elderly. There's so many things that encompass our world today, that there is. It's always helpful to have somebody that can help you manage those expectations, so that you do not make poor financial decisions. And especially, you know, we are living longer, so the longevity issue is another 20 to 25 years.
Yes.
That hadn't anticipated. CPP started in 1965, and now we have people.
What is CPP for people?
It's a Canada Pension Plan. So this is something that we really don't have financial data going back to 1900, because the program did not exist.
Okay.
Universal health care did not exist. So many of these things
are
really recent events, and the longevity factor is going to really test the model.
So that I think that's a concern for a lot of people. Boomers, like you said, are living longer,
mm-hmm.
and maybe they have not, you know, come to terms with the fact that, yeah, I'm going to be 65 one day, and I haven't
mm-hmm.
saved a cent.
Mm-hmm.
How am I going to retire and live off
mm-hmm.
my means? So
mm-hmm.
is it possible to be at a point where you're close to 65 and gather all that together?
Well, I think waiting until 65, it's... To really wait for the government pension, it's not going to give enough. Living in Toronto, with the real estate prices, and even in any other cities, the real estate has developed into not just Toronto centric, but everywhere around the areas. If you go to Bolton, everywhere around the airport is actually the largest concentration of employment. So that area of financial stability and job opportunity has got people actually going within, say, maybe 150 kilometer radius in each way, to Niagara, north, south, east,
outside
and west, Milton. Even when I started York University, there was a farmhouse on Steeles Avenue.
Yeah.
This is no longer.
Yeah.
So the whole real estate model has spread so far that it's essential to really start kids in high school or in grade school thinking about how does the flow of money work? Where does it come from? I was just watching the Leonardo DiCaprio movie, Catch Me If You Can.
Okay, great movie.
And it's a great movie. And so where did he get this understanding of the whole of financial flow of money? Well, I find it kind of interesting because my husband is in the office products business. And so he was the character. He was actually, his father was a New York stationer, and he began to, he understood the stamps, the kind of paper, the typewriters, the type of print. So how did he understand? He knew where the bank tellers were generating, you know,
so
stamps.
He had inside information.
Absolutely,
yeah.
But he was a teenager, don't forget.
And he was a teenager.
So he really understood. And if you get expertise from the people around you, this whole idea of, you know, financial literacy can start from the beginnings of your home life, and can really give you a great
an early start.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah, and I always say that, you know, as an educator, it's important to have financial education for for youth as young as they can understand what money is and the value of money. So it's very important to include that in the curriculum. So thank you for emphasizing that. But I just wanted to ask you, as a female entrepreneur, and I know that you support so many, and I thank you for supporting me as a female entrepreneur, have you experienced any challenges or any barriers? You know, either being taken seriously or just any kind of emotional barriers or physical barriers to being a business owner?
I think there's barriers wherever you're going to accept them. And I think that I think we just need to be around supportive people and just push through. Absolutely. I mean, this financial world is still, I'm going to say, it's still a man's world. But there's certain industries that kind of lend itself to that, just because of the nature of risk. Perhaps in mining industries, there is a risk factor. There's a personal risk, and so I think things will kind of lend itself to that. But I just want to say, great things happen on the Nikki Clarke Show. Latoya Mullings, she's had, since we've met, fantastic success. Fantastic success, and there's so many.
She's a gospel singer, pop R&B singer. She's amazing.
Amazing voice, and I think just being around people that you really want to work with and that will support you, it doesn't feel like work. It'll give a presence, and I think it will it'll get you through that. There's in the financial industry, there is a push to have more female executives. There are proven stats to show that female executives at the helm really can push up the share value. So I think these things are happening, and if we accept the barriers, they're there. But I think we need to, even as young entrepreneurs, or whatever the group is to find a group and work from there. I know that there's. Actually, one of my friends, her daughter has done an entrepreneurial group in the millennial age. And, of course, the Stilettos,
yes.
That group.
Stilettos and Hammers.
I'm going to mention Brian Crombie because he's an amazing networker. And there's so many of the people that I've met through him, Leslie. So I think if you connect yourselves with a nice group of people, they're going to help you. Become not just an expert, but become somebody that can help other people and mentor other people. And
yes.
I think that's the essential thing.
Absolutely.
is to help each other, because as Warren Buffett says, we don't want to appeal to the conscience of America. We want to appeal to its greatness. So everybody has something to contribute, and I think Michael says that being an entrepreneur is not a wish, it's a do. So we just need to do.
Awesome. Yeah. And I like what you do.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. And where can people find you, Sonia?
So my email address is sdollarfinancial@gmail.com. I'm on Instagram, Facebook, and we'll have a website out.
Sonia, you've been an inspiration for so many. Who would you like to thank for inspiring you?
Okay, great. Thank you. Actually, quite a few people. And, of course, you first.
Thank you.
And our friend Lena that we met through. And Raymond Aaron, Mayor Ezra. My friend Debbie, she's in the audience. My family and friends. And also somebody that has gone to India. So Isabella. And Monica, I'd like to acknowledge you guys because you've been part of our group. And Isabella's done amazing work with the veterinarian
yes.
research.
She has.
So yeah. So Thank you so
much. Hi, Isabella. We love you.
And, of course, my family and my mom. Love you. Thank you.
You're blessed. Thank you so
much. Thank you so
much. Sonia Dollar, everyone. We'll be back.
Right. We've had a fantastic show here. The Nikki Clarke Show live at Costco in Scarborough, 1411 Warden Avenue. And I just got to say that I just had to kick back and reward myself for this amazing first time production here at Costco. But I would be remiss if I didn't thank incredible people who supported this effort. So I want to thank first off the gentleman at Costco headquarters, Ron Damiani, for giving me a chance here, and Lori Fogelman for taking good care of us and the staff here at Costco Scarborough Warden. Thank you to Lloyd, thank you to Addie, thank you to Daniel and Roy, thank you to our fantastic guest Sonia Dollar and Casper, and we want to thank my sponsor Angela Gordon and also Glow Academy and Jewel Power. So thank you very much for watching. The show is about transforming lives one story at a time. And if you'd like to be a guest on the show, please contact us at www.thenikkiclarkenetwork.com. God bless and see you next time.